The Bentil Group is a soft tissue and biomaterial mechanics lab. Our lab applies both experimental and computational methods to help us characterize how soft materials, including biological tissues such as the brain, respond to external loads. Understanding how soft materials respond to external loads is invaluable in many biomedical applications. One such application is trying to understand how to design a biocompatible neural electrodes. These neural electrodes are implanted into the brain of an individual with a neuromuscular disorder, such as Parkinson's. So the Parkinson's patient is suffering from tremor. The electrodes are quite rigid compared to the soft brain tissue. So once they've been implanted, the brain rejects the electrode due to that mechanical mismatch between the rigid electrode and the soft brain tissue. Now the question becomes, how can we trick the brain into thinking that the electrode belongs there? So, in order for us to trick the brain, if you will, we need to develop some type of coating around the electrode with a material that behaves similarly to that of the brain, so a brain tissue surrogate. But in order to develop this brain tissue surrogate, we need to understand how the brain responds so that we can design the biomaterial accordingly. So that's one such project. Other projects that we're interested in is understanding traumatic brain injury due to blunt impacts and also blast impacts. We've designed and fabricated a surrogate head system. This surrogate head system consists of a surrogate skull, surrogate cerebral spinal fluid, and also a surrogate brain material. Once we have an understanding of how the brain responds due to repeated head impacts, we'll then be able to develop improved countermeasures, such as improved helmets, to mitigate injury to the brain, such as concussions. Another project that we're working on is trying to understand primary blast-induced traumatic brain injury mechanisms. So think of it this way. You have a member of the armed forces who is in a war-torn area, and this member of the armed forces is exposed to an improvised explosive device, an IED. When the IED is detonated, it creates this shockwave, and propagation of the shockwave through the individual causes injury, and eventually down the road could lead the individual to suffer some type of learning disorders and some emotional imbalance. So the first step is to understand how the brain is behaving. What are the forces the brain experiences? How is the brain changing its shape? How is it deforming due to the propagating shockwave? We've designed and fabricated a series of shock tubes in our laboratory to recreate this shockwave so that we can understand what the brain is doing and we can characterize this response. Once we are able to characterize the response, we can use that data into developing effective countermeasures, perhaps even a liner that we can integrate into the combat helmet to mitigate injury due to the propagating shockwave.